Hi my dear friends, children, students, welcome back to your channel Hikatnama. And in today's 5 minutes video, we are going to see types of pronouns. Don't worry, we are not going to go all in one. No, we're going to go step by step, okay? So today's 5 minutes video, we're going to cover the first pronoun, that is personal pronoun, okay? In personal pronoun, again, there are two forms. It has been segregated into two forms here. Okay. We'll see that one by one. Okay. Let's go ahead. So, your time starts. Let's get ready for personal pronoun. That's the first one, right? Okay. Your time starts now. What is a personal pronoun, children? Pronoun is nothing but a word used in place of a noun is called pronoun, right? But when it comes to personal pronoun, a word used in place of a person, thing, idea or event. Idea or event. In person, what all will come? I, he, she, you, we, they. In person, right? And in thing, what will come? It. Got it? And idea. Idea. Pythagoras theorem. It was whose idea? Yeah, it was Pythagoras' idea. Darwin's theory. Whose idea was that? That was Darwin's idea, right? Isn't it? So ideas, events. It could be a cricket match. It could be a birthday party, a wedding ceremony, a thread ceremony, right? So those are our events here. Okay, huh? So see, he does not know classical music. He does not know classical music. He is what? He is person. Okay, huh? He is person. If it's more than one, person will be people. That means we are talking about people. Right? Huh? Okay, now thing. See the second concept? Thing. Thing means we are talking about what? We are talking about a thing. It goes at 250 kilometers per hour. What? What? Obviously the vehicle, right? Vehicle is a non-living thing. It's a car. So, that's why it is replaced with the thing. Got it here? Now, next comes idea. See, Darwin presented the theory of evolution. So, evolution was whose idea? It was Darwin's idea. It was Darwin's idea. So, okay. So, this, evolution theory is what? That's an idea. Okay. And then, keep me informed about the scores of the match. Match is what? It's an event. Right? Okay. So, a word that's used in place of a person, thing, idea or event in a sentence is called a personal pronoun. Okay. In personal pronoun, again, they are segregated into two parts, two forms. First is subjective pronoun and another is objective pronoun. Okay, so we'll see one by one. Okay, so the first is subjective pronoun. Second is objective pronoun. Let's see one by one. Okay, when it comes to subjective pronoun, what's that? A word used in place of a subject in a sentence is called subjective pronoun. A word used in place of a subject is called a subjective pronoun. Got it? So let's see. First, let's understand this with the example. Okay, same thing. Okay, so subjective pronoun, the sentence will talk about what? It will talk about who. Who and about what? That's what is the subject. Got it? Huh? So, let's see the subject. Okay, see. We should go to the park today. Going park and all is okay, fine. Today also it's okay, but who and all are coming? That's more important. Are you there in the count or not? That's very important, right? Isn't it? So, we. Here what will come? Subject is what? We. Got it? We is the subject. Right? Got it? So, we should go to the park today. So, it's taking the place of a subject. It's taking the part of a subject. Right? Now, see. It is such a nice day. What is such a nice day? It's talking about what? It's talking about the day. Either it will talk about who or it will talk about what? About. It's talking about what? It means what? Nice day. It's talking about the day. It's talking about the day. Okay, that is the kind of day. Which day are you connecting? You're talking about what? You're talking about that. You're connecting that. Okay, and which you and I can enjoy. You and I are? You and I are what? That's the subject that we had used. Remember? Ah. Okay, so the subjective pronoun will always talk about, it will give you a clue. It's talking about whom and it's talking about what. Okay, dear? So that's what is a subjective pronoun. Now coming to objective pronoun. Before we go ahead with objective pronoun, let's first see what all will come in subjective pronoun. Afterwards, we'll go with, to objective pronoun. Okay, in subjective pronoun, what all things can be used? What are the things that you're not supposed to use? See, you're supposed to use who? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 is nothing but your pronoun. Remember, I, he, she, you, we, they, it. That's what is there. Okay, that's what is there. See, I, he, she, you, we, they, it. Right? Got it? So, if it's you're talking about single person, you can use I, he, she, right? Let's understand much better because picture makes you understand more properly, right? See, I, it's me. He is a boy, isn't it? Boy, man. She, who is she? She's the one who comes and helps me for the shoot. Lee, you. Why did a boy? Why I put my picture? Because I'm pointing out where I'm pointing out, that's what is you, right? We, in the picture, I am there. That's why it's we. They, can you find me? No, you don't find me at all. Okay, it's a mom and a daughter, right? Isn't it? It we use for things, right? You already know in personal pronouns we have seen. Let's see in detail. I, he, she, got it? I, he, she, beautiful flowers. Okay, and then you, why you? Because I'm pointing out. I look at myself, I see myself in the mirror. So I'm saying you, we, I'm with her. That's why I say we, right? In we, you must be there. Okay, you, we. They, see, mother, daughter and son are there. I'm not into that. So they, in that you are not there, right? And it is nothing but the trophy, right? It's a thing. So this is what is subjective pronoun. I, he, she, you, we, they, it. That's the list of subjective pronoun. Got it, dear? Okay, now let's go to objective pronoun. I hope subjective pronoun is very clear to you all children. Now, objective pronoun. It will talk about whom, not who. Whom. Give to whom. Give to whom. Okay. I want. Give it to me. I want. Give it to me. Give to me. Okay. He wants. Give it to him. She wants. Give it to her. You want. Shall I give it to you? Should I give it to you? Us. We want. Give it to us. Them. They want. They want. Give it to them. It needs to be taken for the vaccination. Yes, the dog needs a vaccination. Right? Isn't it? The car needs to be, it needs to be taken for the inspection. Right? So, the car also needs repair, right? So, it has to be sent for the survey. Whether the car is working properly or not. You can leave the car for servicing, right? It needs to be taken for service. What? The car. Got it? So, take it. Okay, give it for the service. Got it? So, the objective pronoun will talk about whom, not who. Subjective pronoun will talk about who and about. And objective pronoun will talk about give it to whom. Give it to whom. Got it? I hope by now you would have understood, children. Now, let's compare both. Okay, subjective pronoun, how many? 7. Objective pronoun, 7. So, what will get converted to what? I will become me. I Do you want? Yes. Give it to me. See. Should I give it to you? Yes. I will give it to you. Yes, I will give it to you. We want. Give it to us. They want. Give it to them. See? Them. It needs to be taken. Take it for the service. Take the car for the service. Got it? So you know, when it's subjective, when it's objective, I becomes what? Me. He becomes what? Him. She becomes her. You, it remains you. You remains you. We remains, we becomes us. They becomes them and it remains it. So you and it, they remain the same. Okay, dear? And that's what is personal pronoun. So in personal pronoun, there are two categories, right? Subjective pronoun and object pronoun. Subjective pronoun, all seven it will talk about, right? But when it comes to objective pronoun, I will become me, he will become him, she will become her, and you will remain you, we will become us, and they will become them, it will remain it, and you're sorted. I hope by now you would have understood what are personal pronoun, and we are done, we are sorted. So let's catch up with the second pronoun. That's a surprise. We'll catch up later. Have a great day, children. Bye-bye.